Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Selamat sejahtera. Alhamdulillah kita bertemu lagi dalam kelas mengaji tulis artikel jurnal untuk siri yang kedua. Dan kali ini dah sampai ke slide yang siri yang ke-10. Okay. Jadi siri yang ke-10 ni kita akan masuk di bab kajian literatur dalam artikel jurnal. Okay, kita akan bedah dan bincang untuk menulis perenggan pertama di kajian literatur. Ini bahagian yang pertama. Okey, kita mulakan. Ini contoh artikel yang bertajuk An Empirical Study of the Challenge Facing Zakat and Wakaf Institution in Northern Nigeria oleh Mahdi Ahmad. Yang ini adalah daripada Emerald. Okey, okay, cuba tengok. Mudahnya, secara mudahnya dia mulakan ayat yang simple. Sebab itu juga tema saya untuk bahagian satu ni. Kalau di bahagian atas tu, you nampak saya tulis pendahuluan. So dalam literature review ni, pendek dia ada dua ayat pendek. Dia mulakan, an abundance of research has been conducted on zakat and wakaf. This literature review, comma. However, focus on the research most relevant to the context of the paper. Okay. Tujuan pakcik nak share ni secara mudahnya untuk peringkat pendahuluan, bila kita masuk, sama itu kita dah cover dekat bab introduction ni, bab 1. Bila kita dah masuk bab 2 ni, kita nak mula menulis dalam bab 2. Ini contoh. Secara mudahnya kita boleh buat abundance of research has been conduct of zakat and wakaf. Pendek je. Okay. Ada pakcik buat box kurungan warna hijau tu, this literature review, comma, however, focus on. Okay, jadi ada dua comma kat sini. This literature review, comma, however, comma, focus on. Jadi kita boleh ambil bagaimana kita nak menulis, nak ambil idea permulaan ayat. So ini pun kita boleh ambil. Jadi sebagai salah satu koleksi kita lah dalam menulis tidak terhad pada literature review. Tapi kali ni tema dia adalah literature review. Okay. Ini contoh satu antara yang mudah bagi saya nak tunjuk pendek dia macam mana dia membuat ayat perenggan yang pertama secara ringkasnya. Okay, jadi kita boleh ambil idea ni. Okay, ini paper yang kedua, research status in halal, a review and bibliometrics analysis. Ini pun daripada publisher Emerald. Okay, pendek juga sebab tema dia kali ni. Okay, menarik tentang artikel ni sebab tu saya tulis dia punya tema dia adalah apa itu literature review, apa itu LR. Okay, literature review 2.0, literature review. A literature review is an essential work to be done before initiating any research project. Kurana at all 2019. So apa yang dia tuliskan ni, dia cerita definisi apa itu LR. Mana tulis? Definisi LR tu, dia explain a literature review is an essential work to be done before initiating any research project. Okay, dia sambung. It assess the relevant literature of the area to map the work done and find out the possible research gap which will help in strengthening the body of knowledge. So dia bagi lagi penjelasan apa itu kepentingan literature review. So dia nak find out possible research gap. Banyak kali saya sebut dalam kelas, especially dalam dalam kelas-kelas saya thesis dan artikel, literature review itu adalah bahagian yang sangat penting untuk menzahirkan problem statement. Jadi problem statement juga datang daripada research gap dari problem statement tu boleh datang daripada literature review. Okay. Sebab tu kalau kita buat problem statement untuk bab satu, biasanya kita tulis dulu setakat mana bacaan kita dalam jurnal, kita tulis bab satu tu problem statement. Tapi bila kita dah selesai bab dua, okay, pergi patah balik dekat problem statement, mantapkan balik problem statement. Sebab di setiap habis satu outline atau satu section dalam literature review tu sebenarnya boleh menemukan research gap. Okay, ini menarik kan? Yang paper kedua ni bukan menarik lah. Ada juga yang menulis dalam literature review sebelum dia cerita hal-hal lain, dia cerita dulu definisi literature review. Okay. Paper yang ketiga adalah berkaitan conventional reads, Islamic reads and macroeconomics variable in Malaysia, a review. Okay, paper yang ketiga ni juga daripada Amarul. Pendek dia perenggan ni. Since the establishment of REITs, study on this investment instrument have been conducted in variety of market and form. This session will first focus. Dimulakan ayat. This session will first focus on the overview of national REIT development, followed by, lepas cakap first focus, dia start pula followed by a discussion of Islamic REITs, and then reviews literature of relationship between REIT performance, size and macroeconomic variables. This section conclude with discussion on the hypothesis development in the study that correspond to the research objective. Jadi dia tunjukkan kandungan dalam literature review. Jadi apa dalam dia tulis dalam peringkat ni nak beritahu dalam literature review ni untuk peringkatan pertama nak cerita konten yang akan dikis dalam literature review. Dia start dengan permulaan ayat dia cakap first focus followed by kemudian section concludes. Okay. Okay, yang nombor empat, tajuk artikel ni harmonizing and construction and integrated maqasid syariah index for measuring the performance of Islamic bank. Okay, yang ni pun kita ambil ada dua perenggan dalam literature review ni. Perenggan pertama, yang ni pun sama, dia pecah kategori kumpulan. So kalau kat sini saya secara summary-nya, perenggan dua perenggan ni dia ada first group, second group, third group. Ha, sebab tu kategori ni namanya kategori kumpulan. Okay. Dia cerita kat sini, saya baca. First study which have measured IB performance can be classified into three categories. Okay, dia berstart. The first group comprise comparative work analyze IB and CB with conventional yards such as CAMELS, rating and other financial ratio, benchmark of profitability and efficiency. The second group consists, itu yang kita nak belajar tu. The second group consists of MIGMOS study we have modified the measure of the S component of CAMELS, which sensitivity to the market risk. Itu syariah performance measurements. However, the syariah benchmark proposed with those study have not clear identified the subject matters. The third group include theoretical and exploratory work which usually began with qualitative approach to construct the yardstick follow the use in analyze the IB performance. Jadi, dia explain dia punya literature review punya content tu, dia start dengan first group and then kumpulan the second group and then the third group. Okay, paper yang kelima, title dia adalah Micro Enterprise Development Trainings and Entrepreneurial Competency Among Low Income Household in Malaysia. So, ini panjang sikit perenggan ni. Okay, kat sini dia nak cerita fokus dan teori. Sebab tu saya ada highlight, bukan highlight lah, saya ada box orange bucu paling kanan atas. Saya tahu yang ni bagaimana orang menulis literature review. Kalau kita sendiri nak menulis literature review, nak bertemakan fokus dan teori. Okay, first dia cakap fokus lah. This study attempt to empirical examine. Jadi yang ni pun ayat yang kita boleh ambil lah, sebab tu saya boxkan warna hijau. This study attempt to empirical examine the effect enterprise development training program on entrepreneurship competencies. Entrepreneurship competencies is the aggregate ability towards successful job role performance. So dia nyatakanlah sumber-sumber citation. Among others found that entrepreneurial competency positively impact for performance. Okay, kemudian dia nak cerita pasal teori. This phenomena can be explained by the resource review. So itulah teori dia, RBV. So dia explain lah, RBV stipulate that resources we are own and manage can serve to create and implement strategies to improve effectiveness and efficiency. Siapa kata? Bani cakap. In the context, entrepreneurship competency are resources, capability, trait and skill inherent with the entrepreneur that channel toward increased firm performance. Furthermore, Bani also suggests that firm value creation process solely lies in the owner-manager ability to acquiring the resources. Therefore, fit into the Bani RBV and based on the previous study on focus on macro entrepreneurship, within similar context, you can assume that entrepreneurial competency are owner-managers of firm that identify acquire resources can lead to superior firm performance, wherein such required competencies are triggered by relevant training program. So, dia nak cerita kenapa kesesuaian teori ni. Okay, saya baca keseluruhan lah eh. Sebab untuk peringkat awal ni saya baca kan, ada kalau ada peringkat panjang kan mungkin pakcik ambil lompat-lompat. Tapi dia nak tekankan dekat slide ni bahawa kita boleh tulis literature review, mulakan dengan fokus, kemudian kita justify dengan beritahu apakah teori yang sesuai dalam kajian ni dan kenapa teori itu. Kalau dalam kes ni kenapa RBV. Okay. Okay, kita terus masuk. Itu tadi siri yang ke-10. Kita untuk perkongsian video kali ini, saya sekali jalan je untuk siri yang ke-10, siri yang ke-11 dan siri yang ke-12. Okay, sebab dia ada continuity. Jadi siri yang ke-11, sambungan yang tadi, Okay, untuk bahagian dua. Okay, paper yang keenam adalah understanding purchase intention of university student towards skincare products. Ini tajuk dia lah. Okay. Okay, ditulis ni daripada Universiti Multimedia dan juga daripada Open University. Okay, literature review dia. Okay, dia ada topik. Ha, kat sini literature review dia ada topik. Topik pertama ni, start je literature review. Topik pertama, purchase intentions. Okay, purchase intention refer to that individual likeliness to inquire certain products and is also crucial aspect measuring consumer behavior. Ha, ini nama besar ni, Fishbin dan Aizden ni. Have defined purchase intention as, dia ada buat muka kata, penutup kata, what we think we will buy. Tu dia punya konsep purchase intention. What we think we will buy. Okay. Accordingly, purchase intention can be used to quantify the tendency of consumer to buy a product. And the relationship between these two components is such that the strongest the purchase intention, the greater consumer desire to purchase products. So ada citation. Tadi, kita boleh juga tulis literature review kan, macam-macam cara supaya ini slide ni dan video ni menjadi rujukan. Okay, kita boleh terus masuk topik dia. Ha, macam inilah, dia pergi masuk topik purchase attention. Okay, paper yang ketujuh, household waste separation separations intention and the importance of public policy. Okay, so untuk topik ni pun sama, dia pergi pada topik. Cuma beza dia, tadi tu dia pergi satu topik. Sekarang ni kalau topik dia 2.0 literature review, so dia akan pergi 2.1 waste management policy in Asia, 2.11 waste management policy in Malaysia. So dia zoom piramid. Okay, dia start dengan waste management and policy in Asia dulu, kemudian dia akan zoom untuk waste management policy in Malaysia. So kat sini panjang, pakcik nak tunjukkan slide ni, nak baca memang panjang, jadi pakcik ambil pendek dia. Dia mulakan, waste management is life threatening issues and waste management need to be more sustainable, is need to environmental effective, economically affordable and socially accepted. Okay, betul dia sambung. Okay, untuk 2.1.1 dia mention waste management policy in Malaysia. Okay, based on the ABC plan in 1987 was a nation of beginning a national waste management plan in Malaysia. So dia cerita situasi di Malaysia. This plan attempt to decrease waste generation but has no specific legal instrument to actualize. So kat sini dia cerita dan cerita narrative dia nak cerita tentang situational waste management policy in Malaysia. So slide ni focus on the literature review dan zoom terus pada topik. Beza dia ada 2.1, 2.11. Okay, next. Yang ke-8, the impact of monetary policy on Islamic bank, financial bank level evidence from Malaysia. Okay, paper yang ke-8 ni, okay, dia terus, tadi kan banyak literature review. Okay, ni pun contoh dan banyak je contoh. Saya sendiri pun buat artikel macam ni, saya tak letak literature review. Terus masuk topik. Topik dia, kes ni 2.0 dia, overview of Malaysia Islamic financial industry. Kalau macam tadi, mesti saya mulakan dengan literature review, baru masuk dia punya topik kan. So kat sini dia tak ada literature review, terus jump. Maksudnya kita ada introduction, kita tak ada literature review, kita terus introduction, 1.0, 2.0 terus. Overview of Malaysia Islamic financial industry. Jadi, mana literature review? So dalam topik ni sendiri, itu adalah literature review. Okay. So, bawah overview of Malaysia Islamic financial industry ni, dia cerita sikit Malaysia Islamic financial industry has been assistance for over 30 years. The enactment of Islamic Banking Act 1983 enabled the country first Islamic bank is Bank Islam. Okay, so Islamic Bank, okay, bracket Bank Islam Malaysia Berhad, to be established. Malaysia overall strategy is development of Islamic banking can summarize under four pillar. So dalam case ni, untuk Malaysia strategy development Islamic banking, dia summarizekan dalam four pillar. Menariknya, dia tulis dalam point form, dalam numbering. 1, 2, 3, 4. Sebab tu saya bracket. Okay. Jadi yang last kali nombor 4 tu, practical and open-minded approach in developing Islamic financial interest. So dia ada buat kurungan, maksudnya ada citation kat situ untuk fakta yang keempat ni. Okay, paper ke-9, a proposed human resource management model for zakat institution in Malaysia. Paper ni memang saya minat. Daripada mula saya baca sampai idea ni memang saya minat. So combination antara HRM dengan zakat. Macam mana diorang dua ni, dua benda yang berbeza, iaitu zakat dan HRM, dia gabung, dia integrate, synergize, jadi buat satu paper. Okay, dia sama macam tadi, dia tidak ada literature review. Maksudnya ada tapi tak letak tulis, sorry, dia tak tulis literature review. Dia start dengan importance element in constructing human resource management model for zakat institutions. So dia start ayat dia, this section discuss the typical component of HRM framework that can be found in literature review, found in the literature on conventional organization, namely recruitment, selection, performance appraisal, training and development compensation. These are deliberate from the perspective of Zakat operation in Malaysia. Okay, next, 1MDB, corruption scandal in Malaysia, a study of failings in control and accountability. So paper ni, dia pun sama, the topic dia very simple, dia start aims, corporate structure and funding of 1MDB. So dia cerita lah, 1MDB is begin as the Terengganu Investment Authority, TIA, launched by Menteri Besar Chief Minister of State of Terengganu, Ahmad Said, in February 2009. It was set up as the holding and investment company for the state and was funded initially by bond issue $5 million in September 2009. It changed its status to the Malaysian National Investment Funder under the name 1MDB, full owner by Malaysia government through the Minister of Finance. Ini based pada Ali punya statement. Okay, so macam mana dia tak buat literature, terus di satu topik dan dia explain dengan konteks tu lah. Okay. Okay, number 11, number 11, contemporary issue of form and substance and Islamic law perspective. Okay, so ada perenggan ni pun sama, dia cerita pasal form and substance, the syariah perspective. So dia cerita lah, in principle syariah emphasize that every contract must comply with the legal form, its essential requirement and its nature or implication. This implies that form and substance and transaction are both necessary. Ahmad 2011. However, most Islamic financial products are designed by using series of contract. Debates rise as to whether the effect of each contract in isolation is to be recorded. Hence, recognizing the form of the contract or whether the economic effect or series of transaction is to be recorded, the recognizing the economic substance or the overall operation. So, dia masuk, nak beritahu kasi dia masukkan satu topik. Ha, jadi, ni nak just tunjukkan satu demi satu supaya nanti kalau you all nak tulis literature review, ada banyak idea macam mana nak mulakan penulisan literature review. Okay, next. Do decent working condition contribution to works. Contribution to work-life balance. A study of small enterprise in Bangladesh. Okay, dia pun sama. Start of the art. Idea dia, start of the art. The concept of decent works. So dia cerita lah, the concept of decent work was expressed in the form of quality and labor was presented in the report of Director General of International Labor Conference meeting 87 seasons sessions in 1999. Betul dia sambung lah. Okay, blah 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 blah. Final social dialogue, comprised right of workers is deliberation with the employer regarding with related issues. So ni topik, ini topik juga. Okay, paper yang ke-13, social media and corporate communication antecedents of the SME sustainability performance, a conceptual framework of SME of Arab worlds. Okay, dekat sini pun dia start dengan literature dengan the agenda sustainability. So macam mana nak tulis? Oh, macam ni pun boleh tulis literature review. So dia cerita lah, the sustainability agenda is an issue of the wider spectrums. Okay, encircling issues such as environmental justice, social justice and ecological protection. So, the citation, the sustainability and the subsequent concept of corporate social responsibility are broad concept and they are conceptualized using multiple constructs according to definition given by World Bank. So, dia beritahu juga definisi of World Bank. Lepas tu dia ambil kat bawah tu, social responsibility is the commitment of business to contribute to sustainable economic development, working with employee, their families, the local community and society at the large improve of quality of life in way they are good of business and development. So kat sini you tengok macam mana dia buat. Okay, according the definition given by World Bank, okay, dia bagi citation dan titik-titik. So kita ada buat satu perenggan kecil dekat bawah. Okay. Okay, kita pergi yang siri yang ke-12. Kita straight forward kan, daripada siri ke-10, 11 dan 12. Untuk siri ke-12, kita masuk ke bahagian 3. Okay. Okay, sekejap eh. Okay, tajuk dia, Strategic Improvisations and HEI in Performance. The Moderating Role of Organization Culture. So, HEI tu maksudnya Higher Education Institution. Okay, dia ada topik. Dia selected topik tu Nama dia Strategy Improvisation and Organizational Performance. So itu juga tajuk, maksudnya ini main literature dia sama dengan tajuk tadi. So dia ceritalah, for decades strategic planning has been considered as the only best way of ensuring competitive advantage by corporate leader in the late 1960s. Ketika itulah 1960-an. So strategic planning tu antara yang paling paling terbaik lah, the best way to ensure competitive advantage. However, organizations struggling for survival and that need to adapt to the rapid changing environment and turn to improvisation. So the time and environment change, so kita pun kena mengubah. Okay, kemudian dia kata Sibora, misalnya ada scholars, Sibora define improvisation as the process of overcoming the turbulence facing organization by using available information and structure at their disposal. Improvisation is also defined as the deliberate and substantive conversion of the design and execution process. Okay, ni dia nak cerita apa itu strategic improvisation and organizational performance. So adalah case ni kita boleh ambil ayat for decades, so nak cerita okay, daripada lama pergi yang baru. Lepas tu however, dimulakan ayat dengan however. Okay. Okay, next paper yang ke-15, innovative assignment rubric for ODL. ODL is maksud dia open and distant learning courses, design and implementation and impacts. So kat sini panjang, tapi kat sini menarik, dia buat justification for innovation. So dia pergi pada justification of innovation, sangat panjang perenggan ni. Memang dia ada mulakan dengan assignment rubric can, assignment rubric come in the various form with some having complex description of what learner need to achieve. Various some with a sample specific description. So kat sini kalau saya nak komen, dia jadi satu perenggan yang panjang. Jadi sepanjang antara in between satu ayat ke satu ayat tu ada citation. Kemudian dia ada juga lah however, another challenge, okay, thus, okay. Last kali tu dia buat macam summary. These innovative assignments rubric can be useful for various ODL institution in supporting their learners for formative assessment, especially in assignment writing. Okay, dia cerita berapa-berapa citation. Last kali dia buat conclusion. Okay, paper yang ke-16, can change leadership impact on the staff organization citizens behavior, a scenario of from Malaysia. So ni cerita pasal organization citizenship behavior, a scenario from Malaysia. Pendek dia. Dia masuk theoretical foundation and conceptual framework. Ini pun menarik. Dalam bab 2, dalam bab literature review, mostly ada juga topik ni, iaitu theoretical dan conceptual. Tapi dia full title letak sini, theoretical foundation and conceptual framework. In this study, two different theory including the change leadership theory and organizational citizenship behavior theory. So ada dua teori lah were examined. Each of these is discussed extensively in the next paragraph. So maksudnya tujuan kat sini nak beritahu, okay, dalam kajian ni ada dua teori. Jadi sebelum kita nak cerita specifically satu teori tu, so kita cerita dulu dia punya apa, dia punya intro. Dia nak beritahu first perenggan, dia nak beritahu dalam kajian ni ada dua teori yang akan digunakan dan dia akan terangkan secara extensively selepas ini. Okay, paper yang ke-17, predictors of knowledge and transfer between expatriates and host country national. Share vision as mediator. Okay, so panjang kat sini tapi sama juga macam tadi, tapi yang ni panjang sikit. It's the theoretical justification and literature review. So menarik, kadang-kadang penting kita nak belajar online, tulis artikel. So dekat sini dia nak tunjuk macam mana dia punya online. Lepas 1.0 introduction, 2 tu dia letak kat sini theoretical justification and literature review. Daripada kita letak literature review saja, dia punya idea adalah meletakkan theoretical justification and literature review. So dia ceritalah, 3 theory were used to support the research framework of this study. First is the signal theory. Okay, betul dia cerita. And sampailah 3 teori tu. Okay, paper yang ke-18, an investigation of magnet effects via overnight return, the Malaysian case. Okay, review of literature. Okay, kat sini dia ada cerita macam sejarah. Iaitu dia start 2.1, mula tulis review of literature. Selain pada tulis literature review, kita boleh tulis juga review of literature. 2.1 dia historical backdrop. Historical backdrop. So bila cerita historical backdrop tu, dia start lah research on circuit breaker, spare, prior, two-part commission. So dia cerita macam X sikit lah. So last kali, thereafter more research began getting interest in the magnet effects. Okay, lepas tu dia adalah 2.1, lepas tu dia ada 2.2. Dia ada theoretical research. Tadi dia cerita historical backdrop. So 2, review of literature. 2.1, historical backdrop. 2.2, theoretical research. Okay, paper yang ke-19. Promoting consumer brand engagement and brand loyalty through customer brand identification and value congruity. So kat sini conceptual framework. Yang bestnya ada gambar rajah terus conceptual framework. Jadi dia start dengan introduction. 2.0 adalah conceptual framework. Berbeza kan, macam-macam idea tadi. Theoretical and literature review. Ini terus straightforward. 2, conceptual framework. The conceptual framework as represent in figure 1. So dia tunjuk gambar kat bawah. Kemudian dia kata melibatkan the antecedent and the consequence of customer brand identification. It based on the social identities, or social theories sekali lah. It based on the social identity theories along with the nation for the marketing field of the customer brand identifications and customer brand engagements. The present study model propose that the VC influence customer brand identification with the third influence customer brand engagement, effective brand commitment and loyalty. Okay, itu saja perkongsian kita untuk siri yang ke-10, siri yang ke-11 dan siri yang ke-12. Kenapa saya gabungkan ketiga-tiga ni? Sebab tak mendapatkan satu journey yang menarik bila kita nak menulis literature review. Ini permulaan dalam kita nak menulis literature review. So ada beberapa perkara yang pakcik nak kongsikan supaya awak dapat idea. Kan macam tadilah, daripada literature review, kita nak tulis literature review, tak apa masuk topik. So macam-macam lah, nak start dengan sejarah, nak start dengan theoretical, nak start dengan conceptual, masuk certain specific topik pun boleh. Okay, terima kasih. Minta maaf atas segala kekurangan dalam penyampaian ilmu ni. Mungkin ada sebutan-sebutan pakcik English yang tak bagus. Maaf, mohon maaf daripada pakcik. Okay, semoga you all dapat manfaat daripada konsep ini. Okay, kita jumpa untuk siri akan datang. Okay, terima kasih. Assalamualaikum. Okay, dan selamat malam. Terima kasih semua. Okay.